Good morning, children. Today, we are going to start with our new chapter, Rescue Rex, from English textbook grade 3, for grade 3. Now, it's before going to start with the chapter, we will come to know something a little bit about the importance of pet adoption centers. Now, children, can you tell me, have you heard something somewhere about pet adoption centers? Maybe. Someone will say yes, someone will say no, because many of you are having their own pets at their houses. Many pets like cats, dogs, parrots. But there are many animals which do not get a proper maintenance, a proper care. And they are actually kept on pet adoption centers. Now, a pet adoption center is a process of taking responsibility for a pet that a previous owner has abandoned or released to a shelter or rescue organization. You may know it that due to many reasons the owners generally abandon their pets or release them, set them free in any situation, and these centers actually take care of them. They own a organization. You might have heard about PETA. Now, these centers, common sources of for pet adoptable pets are animal shelters and rescue groups. Some organizations give adopters ownership of the pet, while others use a guardianship model, wherein the organization retains some control over the animal's future use or care. Now, an animal shelter is a pound, actually. It's an animal shelter can be called as a pound. It is a place that which have stray, lost, abandoned or surrendered animals. Mostly there you can see dogs and cats. And sometimes sick also animals you can see. There are wounded wildlife. And they are kept and then rehabilitated. Now before going to start with the chapters, you can see here warm-up exercise is there, A. Where there are names of few animals. You have to take the ones you have seen, okay? We will start. You can say yes. I can hear you, of course. Yes. First, an eagle. I think so, yes. Take there. An earthworm. Yes. An elephant. Some may not be. Okay, you can do it on your own. Your views, your opinions. A cat, yes. A crow, yes. A dog, yes. A house fly, yes. Then a mosquito, many times. Mosquitoes. A mouse, some maybe, some may not, because mouse, yeah, you can. An owl, yeah, some people can say, some can say yes, or some can just do a cross or tick, whatever. Now, B is there. What are the things that animals need to survive? You have to circle them. Now, see here. Water. Yes. Water is required. Clothes. Nowadays, you have seen, like, if you have a pet as a cat or a dog, you are making him comfortable with good t-shirts. And I have seen many animals with dogs, especially with t-shirts. And fruits and vegetables. For animals, then sunlight, trees, then books are there, see, books, and then you can see their food grains, umbrella is there, shoes are there, and at last you can see shelter. Now we'll just start and go through the chapter. Rescue Rex. Now see, what would you do if you saw an injured animal on the road? Would you bring it home? Let's read and find out what Adil does. Here a person, a boy named Adil. What he does? Oh, don't pick that one. She is not very friendly, said the lady at the pet adoption center. Now, pet adoption center, of course, as I've explained you already, you can see here the meaning also. Pet adoption center is a place where stray, sick and wounded animals are looked after. They have taken care there. They may be given away as pets from there. She barks a lot. She may even bite. When we found her on the street, she had been hurt by some mean boys. Mean boys again? Mean means unkind. Not good, not kind. She doesn't trust people yet. Curled up in a corner, away from the rest of a litter. Rest of a litter. Litter here means, you can see the meaning here, some young animals bond together to an animal. Yeah, you can have seen that, no? Dogs, the puppies together, small ones. The dog looked friendly enough to Adil. He knelt down and petted her head. The dog didn't object. Now see, you don't get yourself confused that. Object, now some you people, you students, you can say that object, some object, anything. No, here object, you can see in the sentence, means the dog didn't object, he didn't argued or to disagree with something, to take an objection here, not to agree with, is known as and to take an objection or object. What is her name? Asked Adil. Rex. Adil made up his mind. Rex was the dog he would take home. Adil picked out two bowls from the shelves and his father filled out some forms. For an hour later, they were home with Rex. At first, Rex wasn't too friendly. Now, of course, if you bring one new animal, na, a pet animal, if you'll find it somewhere, you'll bring home, he or she will not feel friendly. The animal will not feel friendly because you people are very much new to them. Then what she did, she barked at strangers and sometimes even at friends. But Adil took good care of her. What he did? He fed her, bathed her, took her for long walks and even cleaned up after her. And what happened after all? He did everything what she was actually expecting. In a few weeks later, Rex cheered up. She became playful and affectionate. Affectionate is loving, caring. Okay, then Adil could let her run free in the park. She wasn't going to harm anyone. So Adil was very surprised when one evening Rex stood by a bush and barked like crazy. Crazy things? Crazy, what do you understand, student, by the word crazy? What do you mean by crazy? You can see here, crazy means here a lot, means crazy, like crazy. Anything you do, a lot things, crazy, different things. Sometimes something's wrong. Here something's has given a particular meaning. Something is, something's is contracted of something is. Thought Adil and ran to Rex. There on the ground lay a small sunbird. Have you ever heard about sunbird? You can go, if you are having the test book right now, you can go down, you can know more about sunbirds. Are some of the smallest birds found in Asia, Africa and Australia. And they have bright colored feathers. The picture is there. They drink sugary water found in flowers called nectar and eat tiny insects. Oh, see, you can see the bird. Now, here Rex refused to move. Adil took a closer look at the bird. How caringly, affectionately he is looking. See. It seemed to be hurt, but it was breathing. Adil took out his handkerchief, placed the bird in it and carried it home. Rex stopped barking and followed him. You found the bird just in time, said Adil's father. They put the sunbird in a shoebox with some old socks. Then they fed it some sugar syrup. Sugar syrup? Have you taken some time a sugar syrup? A thick sweet juice, if you have sometimes, if you have had gulab jamun, lovely sugar syrup of that, have you ever tasted it? It is very sweet. Now Rex breathed on the sunbird to keep it warm. Soon the bird was moving on its own. The bird will be fine, said Adil's father. Dad, I think the lady at the center was wrong, said Adil. How so? Asked his father. Rex is a kind and friendly dog. She just didn't see it.